Hello everyone, how you all doing? Which two world anvil templates of article templates am I well known for? None. I'm not well known for any. Oh, I see. Thank you, Forge. I see that they're out in force. Thank you, Nick. Really appreciate you being on that. Hello, right? Which two do I think I'm good at? Character and item, I think, are the ones I'm the best at. Genital wart. Hey, AG, it's the Living Dead Girl, guys. We need a walk-on for you, AG, because, like, you're the Living Dead Girl now, and... Living Dead Girl. I'm doing pretty good there, Billy. So how is everyone else today? Nick's on the ball with the hosses. Finish your ship article, Dads. That's awesome. And Billy's having a night off of writing. Okay. One upset with another. Oh, I hope you're all right now, James. That's where you get scratches behind the ears. It helps. Shitful AG, I'm sorry to hear that. Yeah, we'll take a peek at it there, Daz. Oh, good. Good. Some first COVID shots for the kids is good. Oh, my God. Is she okay there, there, AG? That'll annoy the shit out of her in a few days. Raid? Oh, more hoss. It's a hoss raid. Rate of horse shit. Did you get him? Do you need help there, Forge? There. Nick. All right. Thanks, mate. That's awesome of you. Oh, yeah. We'll take a boo at that one after we look at this article. Ah, thanks, Billy. I'll hydrate. Hail, hydrate. pretty awesome there, Daz. I like it a lot. Slap a big old like on that. That's pretty awesome. With a map of the jolly boat showing what it looks like. Right. Nice. Just a second, guys. I'll be right back. Back with hazelnuts. Okay, so you put something in the Discord and Sable's general channel. Okay, I'll take a look here. I've been in general channel for some time. Oh, hey, yeah, I remember that picture. If you're trying to find Thomas Kidd, good luck. That painting's about 40 years old. Aaron, would you ever do a community cell stream like Sable did the other day and ever and again? I think it'd be great fun. Oh yeah, sure. Well, there you go. Shit. I'll see what you can commission out of him if he's still painting. Yeah, no, an artist there. Thomas Kidd. Yeah, he did some art. I'll see if I can throw it up on. That picture is about 40 years old, I have to say. Maybe even older. Yeah. 87, eh? Okay, what's that? 97 and 30 some odd years old anyways. Cruise control and creatine overdose in the Netherlands and Austria. They're suing them. Picture in high definition, yes. I seen that junk in the theaters. Hello, Sparkles. Okay, James, have a good lurk, man. It's going pretty good, actually. I was just reading an article there that says that Twitch is suing two hate raiders. On behalf of the Twitch community. Oh, my posture really sucks, man. Can't you tell? I checked. Coins you made? Sure, yeah. Just check them out. These are coins that Barbarossa made for your world there, I take it, eh? Copper, silver, and gold coins. There we go. Pretty awesome. That's pretty awesome, man. Where did you do those up at? Or are those just like Photoshop? Just paint.net, eh? Okay. That's pretty awesome. Yeah, it's 500 pennies type thing, 50 pennies, 50 cents, whatever your equivalent is, Aidens. Aiden, is that it? Yeah, Aiden, 50 Aiden, half dollar. Yeah, is there a 1 Aiden piece? Can you get a 1 Aiden piece in this world? A little tin coin or something? Yeah. Is there anything that costs less than 10 Aiden, though, is the question. Like, what are penny candies worth? Maybe they're 10 for 10 Aiden or something, and you only get them in groups of 10 or something. Yeah. Makes sense. Yeah. The old Chinese coins used to do that. The old Mongolian coins did that. Some of the old Persian coins did that. Babylonian coins. Centralized money system, eh? Yeah. Yeah. Good idea, Billy. Currency system in your world is very important to note. How much money does the average man make? Right, and what is the average cost of things? Right, is the average man starving, in other words? You know, sailors in Sable's world make a shit ton of money. But they got nowhere to spend it, so they spend it all on like stupid stuff. Yeah. Class divide does add conflict. Be right back, guys. There's a rule that I was just reminded of by my hubby there. All right, the Heinlein rule, which is how many units of currency does it take to buy a loaf of bread, and how long does the average tradesman have to work to gain that unit of currency? And that determines your basis of currency in your world. All right? So if a loaf of bread is 100 aden, and it takes a skilled tradesman 10 hours to make 100 aden, they are poor. And in an industrial economy, as was just pointed out to me, you can replace the loaf of bread cost for the average cost of a breakfast at a restaurant, right? To determine your base economy, right? If the base economy is $5 to buy a breakfast at a diner, right? And it takes the average tradesman 2 hours to earn $5. It's, you know, he's got to work 2 hours to get breakfast, 2 hours to get lunch, 2 hours to get dinner. He's not making much money. Yeah, you got to work 6 hours for your daily food. If you're making $2.50 an hour and the day and a meal costs $5, yeah. Right, think of that old song, King of the Road. Right? You know, trailers for sale or let, rooms to rent 50 cents. No food, no phone, no pets. Ain't got no cigarettes. Right? You know, 2 hours of push and broom buys a 8x12 4-bit room. So that means that in 2 hours he was making 50 cents. And he could buy himself a room for the night. So that's what you gotta base your economy on, is how much is the average skilled tradesman making compared to what it costs to survive. Right? Jeffrey Bezos. And all resemblances to any people, living or dead, is purely coincidental. Personally, I'd make a Cthulhu horror and name him Jeff Bezos. You know, something that consumes planets, Galactus type. Gil Bates, Zark Muckerberg. You are back, James. Welcome back. I am still here. I burnt my finger last night. It was not happy. Dropped my lighter into my lap. Okay, Billy, well, it's nice having you around. What am I leaning against? Resting against? You mean this, this is just my chair. I just threw a blanket over it. All right, Billy, have a good night, mate. No fucks for Haas. Haas gets no fucks. Unless it's up the ass of the wire brush. Oof. Naz. James is a squeezy tiger. Squeezer yet. Sorry about that, folks. Farts deadly fumes. Flicks it back. Boom. Exploding fart. You folks are nuts. The Maya station. Thanks for the follow. Just to let you know, we have a 10-minute timer on follows just to stop fucking hate bots. Right? We're sorry, but we have to do that. Right? It gives our mods a chance to ban any hate raids. I'm sorry. So, if you're still here in 10 minutes, I'll glad to hear from you, and thanks for the follow. You wondering what to write? I don't know how to help you, Moonflower. What are you working on? So many cool shinies. I hear ya, I hear ya. And oh, it was created a few days ago. That's okay. I can't tell time either. You know how I know it's daytime? Because I can see. James is giving out tiger hugs there. That's cool. That's pretty awesome. Doug on Supermanscape. Like I always say, any idiot can grab a tiger by the tail, but it takes a hero to hang on for the ride. Accidentally misspelled Diane twice. Glad you caught that. Okay. Yeah. Could have been awkward, yep. English is not her first language, though, so. English is not my first language either. Gibberish is my first language. their hugs of forgiveness. You know, it's the thing, little dogs don't know they're little dogs. Yeah, gibberish. It's everybody's first language. I just maintained my ability to speak it throughout the years. And it comes in handy for translating Dazzle Caddies. Yeah, I have noticed that when a dog plays in tug of war. It's like, oh, Jesus. Dog all of a sudden weighs 75 pounds. He's a chihuahua. Yep. Okay. You're welcome here anytime, James. Now you've got Daz's dog at my place. Okay, well, show it off then. Stick it up there, I'll throw it on the screen. Ritual of drink. That's cool. Coolios. Yeah, Scooby-Doo ancestor. Scooby-Doo. I
direwolf.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Returns Daz's dog to her. You could have domesticated direwolf. No saying you can't. Yeah. He would have terrorized two of the cats. And the third one would have clawed his face off. He don't run. He's too old and broken to run, so he just fights dirty. Okay, close enough to the hour. I'm going to take my 10-minute break here, and I'll be back in 10. Hello, and I'm back and stoned up. Huh. You need that, James? Don't leave parts of it all over the place. I don't want to find any mountain lion kidneys in my shoe or anything. Different strokes for different folks, Moonflower. Some say tomato, some say tomato. Some say dead animal, some say yum, yum, yum. Sorry about that. Yeah. Oh, I'll look at it sometime. Whose world is Bud Panther? Yours, Moonflower? Cute Moonflower. Cool. Hear you, Daz. Gotta polish that manuscript. You got an editor yet? I'm not volunteering, by the way, because I don't know shit about editing. But I can recommend some good ones. I can recommend some good ones that work for reasonable prices, too. Like Author Goddess. She's the one who edited A Few Good Elves. Yeah. Speaking of which, it's been out now for 3 days. Who's read it? Moonflower James, have you read it? Okay. Yeah. I think the whole thing has been posted for patrons to read at one point or another. Audio copying job, eh? Okay. Hey, we each read in our own way there, Aiden. I have to ask, because I'm not very good at that. MX is sort of like Ms. or Mr., but gender neutral. How is it pronounced? Yeah, Ms., Mrs., Miss., Mr., Mix. Okay. Yeah, thanks. My kitty's weird. She likes having her belly scratched. I'll make sure you get a copy there, James. One way or another, we'll get you a copy. Awesome. They sort the socks for you. They put a pile of socks over here and a pile of socks over there. There you go, between AG and Moonflower, we'll make sure you get a copy there, James. I'm not sure what you mean why Kahuna the Elder is up? Oh. I don't know, is he up? Yeah. He's got Kahuna happy hour in 45 minutes there. Yeah, I hear ya. Daz, I hope everything's going okay for you there. AG. All stories are tragedies ultimately, James. We'll see you get one, James. I'm sure Sable will get cut them a deal, too. I can't speak for her, but you are her most loyal Lapin. We're waiting on typesetting at the moment, so. Hear you there too, James. I've been right there. Well, as I said, you really should talk to AG if she's got the time about editing that novella there, Daz. Alright. And Because she's good. She edited a few good elves. Mod Sakuna, no. He got hotspotted. Nah. That's too bad. Yeah, I'm with it too. Camera's not as important as World Anvil. That's true. James, that is absolutely true. Well, that's feeling I'm trying to set you up a job there, AG. That's why you keep hearing your name. I think it means webcam, don't you? I'm not sure what you meant to say there, Daz, but in a big rewrite, okay. We didn't think you meant it like that. I'm in an N-word rewrite. Camera for James. Amazon. Okay. 42 pounds, that's not bad. Not a bad deal at all. How much is World Anvil membership there for the year for the level you want there, James? £55, okay. So 55, 42, 43 plus shipping, say 50. Gotta come up with £105. You have 80, you say? Well, I'm sure we can figure out how we can get you 25 pounds. Hell, if you went and collected bottles off the side of the street for that length of time, you'd probably be able to, I don't know, actually. In Canada, they give you a deposit on them, but... Cool. We'll figure out how to get you that extra 25 pounds there. James. We'll figure it out. Let's see what Sable says about her book to start with. Right. Like I say, James is her most loyal lapin, and if she finds out he's not getting a book, that she might just want to send him one, or send him one for a cheaper cost or something. I'll be right back, guys. Yeah, I'm sure AG has just got her face away from the computer at the moment there. Daz? Yeah. Don't worry, I'm sure an audiobook will be forthcoming to you. Did you sign up for an audiobook or, I know some people had problems supporting the Kickstarter for various reasons, but. Nah, that's not cheapskate, man. That's awesome. That's, you know, that shows your support. So, you know, you're not a cheapskate. Just because you don't have millions of dollars to throw around like Jeff Bezos, you know. I'm sure that Sable's going to see that an audiobook find its way to you, James. We're still negotiating for... my ship map's going okay. Yeah. I've got one deck done. Yeah. Oh yeah, it's hard to do when you only got that. Like, you see, I've got assets coming out my assets. Right? I can upload assets like freely from other packages I've got, and I've literally got thousands of tokens. Right? Of assets. Thousands of them. For everything from modern to science fiction to fantasy to overland maps to, you know, because I have Campaign Cartographer 3. Assets out my assets, yes. Right, I bought the whole suite of Campaign Cartographer 3, and it comes with all sorts of files that you can just use. You know, make your own tokens and things, so. And if you can get past the learning curve of the program, it's an incredibly good mapper. It's incredible, but it's a bit of a learning curve because it's CAD, right? Computer assisted drafting program, which means that its logic is backwards. You tell it what to do, then tell it to do it, instead of telling it to do this now. You say, do this, now do it. Right? Sort of a, this is what I want you to do, execute function. Alright? We need different music. What are we gonna do here? Hey, Brandon. Yeah, digital mapping is different. I think Brianna's dying in the other room. I hope you did not come over to my house to die, Brianna. Nah, they're in Sable's office at the moment. I'm not sure what they're up to, but they're going to be working on the basement. I got a big orange garbage bin though, so if she dies, that's where she's going. Yeah, goofing off, that's what they're doing. Thanks, James. Hugs back. Brianna is smoking one of Sable's cigars. I think she inhaled, and that's not good. I think she'll live. I'm not her next of kin, so it's not like it's a big deal for me if she dies. Just a second, Phil. We'll be right back. Okay, I just didn't want to do that on microphone. And everyone gets quiet on me. Yeah, well, I mean, it is close to midnight where you are there, James. All right, I'm going to be raiding Kahuna in a matter of a few minutes. All right, yeah, probably 10. All right. Anytime, James. Like a nice, polite boy. Yes, you are, James. Thank you. That's always cool. Especially if these players are in it. Boom! Fireball went off. Save. Fireballs are mean. They do a minimum of 5d6 damage. Right? Which means that on the average, they're going to do, what's that? 3.5 times 5. 15, 17.5 points of damage. And what's the average first level character have for hit points? Oh, they're level 3, okay. They might survive fireball then. TPK before they say a word. Yeah, that's it. Give them a bonus on their save then. You guys get plus 4 to save because it wasn't aimed at you. But fireballs are big. They're 20 foot radius spread. Alright. Okay. You're gonna be nice to them. I wouldn't be. But you are. Gonna be a lot of dead people. Of course they do. The ones that survive the fireball are probably trying to get the flames out. Yep. Just like a bomb going off in a London street. That is bad enough. Yeah, my roommate spilled a drink onto my hubby's computer this morning. What's 97971 CP there, James? Channel points. Ah, okay. I got way too many. I don't know, like 275,000 or something. Yeah, I got like 2 stories worth. No, no puppy here. Puppy and kitties do not get along. Puppy is rambunctious. Kitty is vicious. Puppy would be in veterinarian. He's too old and busted to run, so he just fights dirty. It's like me. Too old to run, too busted to square up, so whatever I'm gonna do is not gonna be pretty. And it's gonna hurt you a whole lot more than it's gonna hurt me. That's my philosophy. Oh yeah, okay. What are you gonna do if they catch him? No, I'm not sure, James. Chartreuse. Okay. So they'll beat up a golem and it has no information. Good. Oh, they'll save the golem and the golem still has no information. Good. Whatever this person was carrying was not affected by a fireball. So it's probably a jewel or a coin or something like that. Piece of jewelry. Right? That people want, that the golem has. Now, what did the golem do with it before the party beats the hell out of the golem? Type of very minor artifact, okay? Sure. Did the golem absorb it into his body? Okay. He stashes it. Okay. So the golem's intelligent. Or at least simulates intelligence, makes decisions. Ah, okay. Sounds like a good start so far there, Des. Okay. It's a war forge, basically. Okay. Alright. It is sentient. And halfling sized. It was 4th edition, I would imagine. Because it wasn't 3.5 that I ever seen. Well, not that I've seen everything, but I've seen a lot. And 4th edition, I looked at the basics of the books and I went, "You suck balls." And never gave them a second look, so. Fourth edition monsters, yeah. Well, that's the end of my stream, folks. We're gonna go ahead and raid Kahuna the Elder. Yeah, there are some cool monsters that they can up with. In 22 hours, we will be on for Right with Aaron. Raid Kahuna the Elder. Wait. Right. Tomorrow we will be writing. Because it's Right with Aaron, and that's what you do with Right with Aaron, is you write. Nah, we all know that's not true. Okay, see y'all tomorrow. Lots of love. Remember our raid shout, prepare to be boarded. We are Sable's privateers after all. See you later, Dad.
About priorities?
Probably.
They can hear that? You weren't talking that loud.
No, but... Yeah.
Something about being upset.
Yes.
Yeah.
So anyway, here we are. Welcome to Happy Hour. Welcome, friends. Welcome, Sable and crew. It's been a week. Like, a hell of a week.
Oh, apparently Dean's heard something while going downstairs.
Oh, yeah, I was sitting here when I said about something out here.
Oh, was that when I was, like, telling him I was upset because he told me my nightgowns were here, but he didn't go down to get them? That was probably what one of them was.
Probably. I really got to remember to shut things off.
Mm-hmm.
Author Goddess is here. Welcome. Yes, the coral automatically shuts off the